Hello students, so in previous class already we discussed about the theory as well as synopsis of aldehyde ketones. Okay students, so in today's class we will discuss the most important multiple choice question which is asked in JEE NEET as well as KCET exam. Okay students, so we will discuss one by one MCQ questions. So see the first question which is mostly asked in JEE NEET as well as CET exam. So when phenol is treated with CHCl3 means it is a chloroform. When phenol, you know the structure of phenol, okay, benzene containing OH, when phenol is treated with chloroform and NaOH, means sodium hydroxide, the major product formed is, okay, so very simple question they are asking students. Phenol is treated with, means phenol is reacts with chloroform as well as NaOH. So this is well familiar naming reaction students, you know that. Okay, so when phenol is there, chloroform is there and sodium hydroxide is there, so obviously the name of the reaction is which one? So this is a Raymer-Tamer reaction. Okay students, see which options they are given. Option A, ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde. So when phenol is reacts with chloroform as well as NaOH, whether it get orthohydroxybenzaldehyde, option A. Option B, they are given parahydroxybenzaldehyde. Okay, option C, orthohydroxybenzoic acid. And option D, parahydroxybenzoic acid. Okay, which is the correct option? Okay, option A, B, C, and D. Okay, so first of all, you come to know which reaction this one? This is a Raymer-Tamer reaction. You know that when phenol is reacts with chloroform as well as NaOH, so obviously what function of the product will get? Obviously we will get an aldehyde group. Okay, so that means when phenol is reacted with chloroform, so benzene containing OH, that is the phenol, so obviously what should you get here students? So the major product should be orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. So this is the correct answer. Option A is what? Correct answer. Now clear everybody? So orthohydroxybenzaldehyde, this is the major product which you get in a Raymer-Tamer reaction. So this question, so many times they will ask in JEE as well as NEET, as well as in so many common entrance test exam. Okay students, allow to understand. So in different way also they will ask the question. Okay, so how they will ask the question? Sometimes they will give the reactions. How they are given the reaction? They are given the phenol plus NaOH plus chloroform, and they are given the product also, orthohydroxybenzaldehyde, and they are asking the given product, what is the name of this reaction? Okay, they are given the four different options, Raymer-Tamer reaction, Olbers reaction, like this they are given the four different options. So students, you remember this is a Raymer-Tamer reaction. Okay, now I understand. I will discuss the second question. Reaction of phenol with chloroform. Okay, again same question, but they will ask in different way. See how they are asking like this. Reaction of phenol with chloroform in the presence of dilute NaOH. Now finally introduce which one of the following functional group. Okay, so same reaction is there, Raymer-Tamer reaction is there, but they are asking the question in different way. Okay students, so whenever you have to solve the JEE NEET questions, you clear your concept. If you clear the concept, then only you can easily solve all kind of the questions. Okay, so very easy questions. So if you know the Raymer-Tamer reaction, so you come to know which functional group is present in the Raymer-Tamer reaction in final product. Okay, so obviously, so option A, they are given the COH is carboxylic group, so it is not present there. Then CH2Cl2, it is also not there. And option C, CHO, means it is what? Aldehyde group. So obviously students, in Raymer-Tamer reaction, aldehyde group is there. So already we discussed in previous question, what is your major product? Orthohydroxybenzaldehyde, means aldehyde group should be there. Okay, now all of you understand how they are asking the question on the basis of Raymer-Tamer reaction. See the another question students, so it is also very important question. Which of the following reaction will not produce ethylene glycol? Okay students, whenever you solve the questions, you read the question carefully. Okay, sometimes what happens, directly you can give the answers. That time some mistakes is going on. Okay, so to avoid that, before you solving the reactions, you read question carefully. Okay, what they are given, what they are asking, that is very important. Okay, so which of the following reaction will not produce the ethylene glycol? You know the structure of ethylene glycol. This is a very simple structure. 2 hydroxy group is there, OH, CH2, CH2, OH. Okay, this is what ethylene glycol. Okay, they are given the 4 reaction and they are asking which of the following reaction will not produce this structure.
This one, ethylene glycol.
Okay, we just check it. So option A. So they are given the epoxide. CH2 or CH2. Okay, this is a cyclic form. Which one? Hydrolysis. Students, obviously, very heating. What happened here? The bond will be breaking from here. Okay? After breaking the bond from this H2O, the OH group will attach here and the hydrogen will attach here. Means what will get here? OH. CH2, OH, CH2H. Means obviously we will get ethylene glycol. So, in this we get ethylene glycol, but they are asking which is not produced ethylene glycol. Okay, so we'll check the C option, option B now. So they are given Cl, CH2, CH2, Cl. Okay, dichloroethylene they are given. Okay, or we can say it is 1,2 dichloroethylene. So which one hydrolysis? So which one reacts with water molecule? Which one heating? What do we get here? So obviously, if you take the excess of water molecule, so HCl will be removed and 2 hydroxy group will join here and here. And obviously, we get what? Ethylene glycol. So, option B also we get the ethylene glycol. We will check the option C. So, they are given OH, CH2, CH2, OCH3. So, which functional group is present here now? Ether. So, it undergoes hydrolysis. It does not produce ethylene glycol. Already here OH group is there, but here they are given the ether functional groups. So, that's why students obviously answer is what? Option C is your correct answer. Now, clear? So they are asking which of the following reaction will not produce the ethylene glycol. So just check it. If option C, if you do the reactions, you can't produce the ethylene glycol. That's why your correct answer is what? Answer C. Hello, you understand? So students, I will do the 10 seconds. You just take the screenshot and note down these all MCQs. Okay? And again, we'll discuss the further MCQs. Just take the screenshot. Okay, students, just see the fourth MCQ. So, this is very, very important MCQ. So many times they are repeated in JEE as well as NEET exam. Okay, so first of all, you see the MCQ. Phenol is distilled with zinc. Okay, phenol is distilled with zinc dust followed by the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Okay, so phenol is distilled with zinc dust, then it followed the Friedel-Crafts alkylation with the propyl chloride in the presence of aluminium chloride AlCl3 to give the compound B. Okay, so compound B are there given, and again B is oxidized in the presence of air to form the compound C. Okay, the structural formula of compound C is what they are asking. It is very easy questions, or orally also we can solve this answer. See, phenol is distilled with zinc dust. Already you know the reaction. Phenol reacts with zinc. So what we will get? Obviously, we will get a benzene ring. Okay, so zinc can abstract the oxygen, it forms the zinc oxide. And obviously, first step here will get what? Benzene. And that benzene followed the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction in presence of propyl chloride. Propyl chloride structure CS3, CH2, CH2, Cl. Okay, Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction is very, very easy. So what happened? That propyl group going to be attached to the benzene ring, obviously. Okay, and again, that is your compound B. Okay, so the compound, which one? Propyl group which is attached to the benzene ring after the alkylation reaction. That is your compound B. And that B is oxidized in the presence of air to form the compound C. So this is what? So when Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction takes place, what is the product that is? That is a cumene. Okay. So in phenol already we studied the preparation of phenol by using the cumene. So next step is what? Here we get cumene. that is a benzene ring, CH, CH3, CH3, that is cumene. So these oxidize, means cumene is oxidized, means in presence of oxygen, so it undergoes oxidation, so the compound C is what? So this is your product, just see, cumene undergoes oxidation, so what we'll get, we'll get what? Cumene hydroperoxide. So in option A, there is no structure, benzene is CH, it is not produced. Option B, so this is benzene ring, then this carbon, CH3, CH3. Okay, again, by each of oxidation, it forms what? Cumene hydroperoxide. Okay, after adding that to oxygen. Already you know the preparation of phenol by using the cumene. So when cumene undergoes, cumene, first of all, what should you do? We can treat it with oxygen, O2, and it forms the cumene peroxide. Again, we can heat, they can break down the compound, and we will get the phenol. Okay, you know that reaction. Okay, so that reaction you also can refer to solving the answer very easy. So the structural formula of C is what? This is the intermediate which is formed during the preparation of phenol by using the cumene. Okay, so that is the name of this product is cumene hydroperoxide. Already you know that. Okay, option C, they are given the phenol. Again, here they are given the cumene hydroxide, but here they are attaching the OH group. So don't confuse option B and D. So obviously your answer is what? Option B is your correct answer. Now clear students? So this is very easy question. So phenol is still with zinc, means phenol when reacts with zinc powder or zinc dust, so obviously they can absorb the oxygen and it forms the benzene ring. Again, it follows the Friedel-Crafts alkylation in the presence of propyl chloride. Means what we get here, product B is nothing but your cumene, and that cumene which on oxidation in the presence of air, so obviously what we get there, so cumene hydroperoxide, and that option is given is in option B. So option B is your correct answer. Now clear students, see the fifth MCQ. So this is very easy question, mostly in CET they will ask this question. It is not asking NEET as well as JEE, but commonly they are asking in KCET exam. Okay, so the carbolic acid is, the carbolic acid already known, carbolic acid is nothing but what? Phenol. So obviously check it, option A, phenol they are given, option B, phenyl acetate, option C, salol, and option D, benzoic acid. So obviously what is answer students? Phenol. So phenol is nothing but carbolic acid. It is another name of phenol, you remember, understand, carbolic acid is nothing but phenol. Okay, that is another name. So that's why answer is what? A. Option A is the correct answer. See the sixth MCQ. In the reaction of phenol with chloroform. Okay, again remember the reaction is there. Phenol is there, chloroform is there, NaOH is there, then obviously it's a Lehmann-Thiemann reaction. See the students, in one reaction how many questions they will ask. Okay, they will ask the question in different way. And just check it, how they will ask that question, and you try to convert the any concept in the form of questions, then you can easily solve. Okay, just check it. In the reaction of phenol with chloroform and NaOH at 70 degrees Celsius, means at 343 degree Kelvin temperature, the electrophile attacking the ring is, which electrophile is generated, when you can see the mechanism of Reimer-Thiemann reaction, you come to know students, chloroform, they play a major role there. Okay, so first of all, chloroform will attack, and after attacking, what happened there? So they can lose the Cl group, and it form the, firstly they will form what? They can lose the hydrogen, it form the CCl3. Just check it, we will just see the mechanism. Okay, so option A, they are given, first of all you see see the options. Option A, they are given the chloroform itself. Option B, CHCl2. Okay, option B, CHCl2. Option C, CCl2, means carbon dichloride. And option D, COCl, means carbonate dichloride. So which is your correct answer? Okay, so just take it, what we are using in Reimer-Thiemann reaction, we are going to use the chloroform. So here I have taken the chloroform. So when it reacts with this, means obviously chloroform reacts with NaOH, in the NaOH group is present. So this NaOH group can abstract this H plus ion. So it can abstract it in form, it can lose the water molecule like this. This OH and this H minus H, so water may not, CCl, like this, CCl, carbon trichloride. It is not stable of stress, it can lose the one more Cl, like this, and it forms the CCl2. So this CCl2, carbon dichloride, it is what? it is an intermediate which will attack on a benzene ring. Now understand, so many times they are repeated the question on the basis of such reactions. Okay, so that is a carbon dichloride. In a different way also they are asking. So what they are asking, during the Reimer-Lehmann reaction, which of the following intermediates will generate? They are asking chloroform, then carbon dichloride, carbon trichloride, like this. So answer is what? Carbon dichlorides. Okay, see here, carbon dichloride, this is the intermediates which is generated during the Reimer-Lehmann reaction. Well, understand students? So in the next class we will discuss the further MCQs. Okay, so before that you just take the screenshot. I will give a 10 second to take the screenshot and note down the all the MCQs. So thank you so much.